This is the output of two Sega Mega Drives that I have. I bought these two from eBay, and both of these display the graphics like this. I expect it's a faulty RAM, so what I'm going to do in today's video is to try and replace the RAM and see if that fixes the graphics problems. So this is one of the Mega Drives with the faulty RAM, and you can see that it's been battered. It's full of rust, probably stored in a shed somewhere. And I've taken out the RAM already, and I'm going to replace it with a donor board. The donor console is in much nicer condition, as you can see, but somebody has attempted to gouge out, look at these pins. I don't know what someone's been up to. Looks like they've tried to replace that chip, but they've gouged the pins out. There's multiple traces that have been torn off. So I'm going to use this as a donor board. We're going to take these RAM chips off. We're going to transplant them into the other board, and we're going to see if that fixes the graphics issue on that one. Okay, so I've removed the heatsink from the board so I can get to these video RAM chips. And now I'm going to apply these other pins here. I'm going to apply some extra solder. Fresh solder. That's it. Not the easiest thing in the world. That is the second one out. To clean these up, and get the solder off them. Some extra flux on the pins. I'm just taking a hot soldering iron and I'm just wicking off the solder there. I want to check to make sure that there's no bridges at the base of the pins. So now probably comes a difficult part. We'll clean them up with some alcohol, and then the difficult part is probably going to be getting them in the holes. The old board still has some solder, old solder in the connectors. So I'm going to attempt to, I'm going to remove that with a solder sucker and some fresh flux. Seems to be going quite well on these ones I've done. Right, after some perseverance, it took a while, but we've got all the holes cleaned out. I've got the two cards video RAM fitted. They just need to be soldered in place, and I'll be able to test it. Okay, I have resoldered all those pins. They all look good. I've checked them with the microscope. So now it's time to test this. We'll get the hooked up back to the TV and we'll see if it's worked. I'm pleased to say I think that's a fix. I'm waiting for some text. The graphics weren't the best at the times. There we go. That's a definite fix, I would say. I can put this back together now. So it was. So if you've got corrupted graphics on your Sega Mega Drive, you need to get some new RAM chips put in there, some new video RAM. I'm over the moon that's worked. I cannot be more happier. Thanks very much for watching. If you've got any comments or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below, and I will see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.